Welcome to Second Bull Run in Ultimate General Civil War, playing the Union. I'm Major General Difficulty with the JMP mod. There have been a number of revisions to this battle in the current mod version. First, the old Day 1 evening skirmish at Bronner's Farm has been eliminated. So Day 1 now starts with what was Phase 2 of Day 2 in the previous version, titled Assault Jackson Again, when it starts. Now there are two phases in Day 1, lasting a total of 5 hours and 10 minutes. You can end the battle early on Day 1, however you must capture the VP and hold it through the contested timer, which is 40 minutes before the mission timer expires. If the contested timer is still running when the mission timer hits zero, you will go to Day 2. Like Shiloh, Day 2 no longer resets your units. You begin exactly where you were at the end of Day 1. I feel like you have to decide before the battle whether you want to go for the Day 1 victory or go to Day 2. I think the battle's probably easier taking it on Day 1. If you go for a Day 1 victory and don't make it, you're probably screwed for a number of reasons. The first being that your units are likely to be low on condition. Second, if you didn't save any money to refill your supply wagons when you switch to Day 2, then you're probably very low on ammo. Third, you now have 3 VPs to contend with on Day 2 rather than just the 1. And if you didn't plan on going to Day 2, then you probably don't have any units that are near those other 2 VPs. Fourth, the CSA reinforcements coming in on Day 2 have been significantly increased, and they will be fresh and full on ammo. If the CSA has 50k on Day 1, don't be surprised if they have another 50k on Day 2. So unless you had the manpower and ammo to handle up to 100,000 over 2 days, it may be a bad idea to go to Day 2. Keep in mind that the enemy army numbers you see displayed in the core deployment screen do not account for splits. That is the number if no unit splits. The default split is 20%, which can be found in the AI config file as duplicate random probability. So whatever that number is, it's likely 20% higher in reality. Plus, in order to boost reinforcements for the AI in this version of the mod, Panda Kraut has forced splits in some battles, and the second day of Bull Run is one of those. This is most noticeable if you happen to have 6 in recon, because the Day 2 deployment screen may show the CSA having 33,000 men. But as soon as you start the battle, you can check the battle balance bar at the top and see that the CSA actually has over 50,000. Also, the CSA reinforcements that come in on Day 1 have their spawn location changed, so it's not possible to intercept them. In version 1.27, I would feign an attack to the right while sending a large force to the left, intercept and eliminate the Day 1 reinforcements, and then attack the VP from the left side. You can still attack from the left if you want, but since it's a much longer march to get into position, you may find that it's not worth it to use up valuable time. Before building out my army here, I did use reputation points to take 5,240 Lorenz rifles, 8 20-pound Parrots, and 655 Burnside carbines, along with both officers, Brigadier General John Reynolds and High-Level Colonel Winfield Hancock. I have more weapons than I need, so I don't need to take the SP-61s. After Second Bull Run, there will be a huge cache of rifles to get with reputation points, so I'll wait for those. I do have Brigadier General and Colonels in the Academy that I could purchase, and my officer corps got beat up at Malvern Hill, but I didn't want to blow all of my cash on officers, so that's why I took these 2 with reputation points. Regarding deployment, you can take up to 3 corps. The 4th Division and 1st Corps will not deploy unless you go to Day 2, so you may find that it's not worth it to even create a 4th Division. The 4 infantry that I have here will not deploy, and they are just new recruits, so they'll get 5 points in each stat not deploying, since I have 10 in training. You will start the battle with 15 units from 1st Corps. I'm taking most of my rifled guns at the start of the battle to start softening up the fortifications to the far right. The infantry and 1st Division are along to protect the guns from the detached skirmishers that the AI will deploy to scout out my units. I will move one of my snipers into 4th Division just so I can field that division commander to get some XP for him. 40 minutes into phase one, you will get 1st and 2nd Division of 2nd Corps, which is about 2 hours left on the mission timer. That group will include my 2-star infantry and my smoothbores that will move forward to support the invasion once I am ready. 1 hour and 40 minutes into phase one, which is an hour left in phase one, you will get 3rd and 4th divisions from 2nd Corps and 1st and 2nd divisions from 3rd Corps. That includes all of my cavalry, some smoothbores, and the rest of my infantry. Once these guys arrive and get into place, I'll start my push up to the ridge. 30 minutes into phase 2, you will get your 3rd and 4th divisions from 3rd Corps. I'm using all skirmishers with mostly the light infantry perks for the speed bonus here, so they can move in quick and provide fresh units with full ammo just before I take the VP. My career points are 5 in politics, 10 in training, 5 in AO, 3 in logistics, and 6 in recon. I will get 5 points in the medicine next, leading up to Antietam, and then get AO up to 10 before Fredericksburg. My first 2 corps supply wagons will take most of the ammo, and I have another 20K in the supplied wagon for 3rd Corps. Once you get units on the ridge up on the top to the right, you should be able to steal a few of the CSA ammo wagons. The Union is on the defense at Shiloh, Gaines' Mill, and Malvern. Now we'll be on the attack for at least the next 3 major battles, here at 2nd Bull Run, then Antietam, and then Fredericksburg, so I expect a fair amount of casualties in each one of these battles. You're trying to find the perfect balance of being patient enough to allow your artillery to soften up the fortifications and support your ground assault, while still being expeditious enough to take the VP before you run out of time. Enjoy the battle, and I'll comment some more at the end. I could have played it just a little bit slower and let my smooth bores do more damage at the top of the ridge. I had 15 minutes of wiggle room between the contested timer and the mission timer, but overall it went pretty well. I had about 12,000 total casualties, which would be 26% of my force. The AI lost 56% of its force. I had a bunch of promotions and picked up two more major generals, though four of my division officers were killed or wounded. Thank you for watching, and I'll start on the Maryland campaign headed up to Antietam.